हरिओ श्री राम अंबाज्ञ नाथ सवित नाथ सवित नाथ सवित. सो हाय बड़ी सॉ यू ऑल वेल डूइंग वेल यस सडनली बट मेनी ऑफ द गैंग्स ऑफ यंगस्टर्स डिस्कस विद ईच अदर. Babu always say this, Natha Savit, Natha Savit, Natha Savit, three times. We also say, we have understood a little bit, Babu, but not yet understood totally. So I decided, okay, chalo, let us talk today on what is Natha Savit. Okay? What is Natha Savit? For that, we have to understand what is Natha first. Nath is the word, Sanskrit word, which is made up of two words, Na and Atha. Na and Atha means, Atha means, Na Atha means, before this there was nothing. Before this there was nothing. Okay? So that is what is called as Natha. Okay? Everything is beyond this. That is Natha. Atha. Natha. Okay? Understood? Okay? Atha is something which is beyond this, and Natha, Na Atha is something which is beyond everything. Before this, before which there was nothing. That is Natha. And their primordial existence, their primary existence, their basic existence, their basic power, their basic supreme power, their basic sovereign power, their sovereign existence is called as Parabrahma. Para means the ultimate Brahma. And that is what we label it as. We give the name as Brahma. She is a name, given the name of Datta Guru or Parameshwar. He is alone. He is himself. He is in, by himself always. Always in that mode. That does not mean we describe as Nirgun Nirakar means that way. To translate just world to world is word to word is Nirgun Nirakar. There is no shape and there are no qualities. But that is not the meaning. He is in such a state where a common human being, even the well-educated human being, cannot understand his form and his attributes and his qualities and his ways of action, his ways of existence, and ways of functioning. That is called as Nirgun Nirakar. And Sagun Sakar is something which is within our limits of grasping capacity. Within our limits of our own perception. That is called as Saguna Sakar. So this Datta Guru is Nirgun Nirakar. He is alone. He is by himself. And how is he? He is Sat Chit Ananda. Sat Chit Ananda means Sat Chit Ananda. Sat means pure existence. Chit means to be becoming or being aware of it. So first is being itself. Then being aware of. And when you become aware, and because of that awareness, the bliss that is produced, the perfect happiness that is produced, that is Ananda. Perfect happiness. Perfect. Without a dot on it. That perfect happiness is Ananda, Satchidananda. So the Datta Guru is always in the state of bliss, happiness, Ananda. Always. And it always exists. It is never that he never existed, never, will never exist. But because of his own swabhava, his own swabhava, swa means self, bhava means his own nature. Okay? Because of his own nature, his own existence, the way he is. Actually, call him he or she is wrong. Somewhere we have to use the word, so we are using the word he, okay? He develops a desire, I am one. Ekosmi bahusya. Ekosmi, I am one only. Let me become multiple. Let me become the enjoyer of the huge crowd, huge existences, huge expansions and everything. And absolutely with that desire, then he himself transfers himself in spite of being himself. He remains as himself. And still, he transforms himself into two forms. To use the word form also is not correct. Okay, for understanding, we say two forms. That is Maa Jagadamba, that is the mother form, and the father form, that is Sahaja Shiva. Dattu Guru is called as Achintya Shiva. The Shiva that cannot be Achintya, that cannot be understood, that cannot be contemplated on. Okay? That is Achintya. He himself transforms himself into Sahaja Shiva and Jagadamba. They are also called as Narayan and Narayani. Right? Sarva Mangala Mangalye Shive Sarvartha Sadike Sharanye Trambake Gauri Narayani Namostute. So Hari and Hara are not different. Narayan and this is Shiva are no different. And when this couple is formed, the primary couple is developed. The love bond between these two and with their original, the grandfather. His grandfather does not mean in our language, father's father or mother's father only. But a grand, what a grand celebration. In that meaning, with that meaning, this great grandfather, okay, the Dattu Guru, this Maa Jagadamba and Sahaja Shiva, Narayan and Narayani, these three are called as Naths. There are three Naths. And the love bond between these three, love bond between Sahaja Shiva and his, you can call her his wife or his own shadow or his own counterpart, whatever you want to call it, everything fits her. She is the creatrix, okay? So she is the creation herself, and this whole world is made out of her only, and she is the creator also. That is called as creatrix, right? So the love bond, not bondage, love bond. The love between Sahaja Shiva and Shiva, Jagadamba, is Swayam Bhagavan, Trivikram, who is called as Brahma. Okay? He is the Brahma himself. The Brahma effulges from him, from the Swayam Bhagavan. And afterwards, obviously we know, the Omkar, the Pranava, is absolutely the original creation, right? Which is in man's reach. Omkar, the Pranava, the whole world, therefore from the Paramatma, his three forms are developed, Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh, Prajapati, Brahma, Mahavishnu, and Paramashiva. And then the whole universe, all the universes are produced, are born, are created, are manufactured. In the same way, we human beings also are manufactured, produced and reproduced, because we are souls with the body. We are not body with souls. We are souls with body. And every time, whenever a human being is born, is given birth with such a way, at such a place, in a such a family, in such a condition, in order to fulfill his previous birth's desires. In order to fulfill his previous birth's desires, one. Second, in order to remove the mistakes and sins which he has committed or done in his last birth, and to improvise on it. Three, to gain better and better knowledge what the Maa Jagadamba and Swayam Bhagavan is. And fourth, to understand where we have come, this Mrityulok, right? This Prithvi, this earth, is not our permanent station. It's not our permanent house. Our permanent house is where the Swayam Bhagavan stays, the Vargalokam, right? We are sent here in the boarding school, right? And with everybody's birth, these three, they create one plan for him, a specific plan for everybody, a specific plan, a special plan, a different plan, absolutely objective plan for everyone, suiting to his particular previous births and the new birth. With that, he is born, he or she is born. And that is Natha Sovet. This plan is not a dead plan. It's not like a map. See, rivers in the map. River in the map. Will that river be able to fulfill your thirst? Will it be? No. So that map is that way of no use. It only shows, directs, that's all. But this map of our life, this plan, is a live plan because it works. River in that plan is going to come to you and fulfill your desires, your thirst, your everything. We want to protect you. This Natha Swabhyam, that is the basic plan for us, made by Ma Jagadamba, Sadashiva and Datta Guru. And that plan is handed over to Swayam Bhagavan, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And he has the freedom to change many things, to make a partiality. He is created for that only, out of love only. Right? So for love, he does the partiality. And he goes on changing plan. Like you, everyone, we all of us, have karma swatantra, that is freedom of action and thinking. Same way when he has the freedom of thinking and action, given by his own mother, right? So he has that freedom, he uses that freedom to the ultimate level set at every stage. But for whom? There is only one condition Jagadamba has kept forward in front of him, that the one who doesn't love her son, the one who doesn't love her son, that is Swayam Bhagavan, will come into the domain of her lords. There he has no scope to interfere. Because when she made him the emperor of all universes, Ananta Koti Brahmanda Nayak, she gave him that power, she gave him that responsibility. She also saw to it that his world should prevail. And for that she made this law. The one who doesn't love him will fall into the domain of her laws, which are very stringent. You do this and get it written that much only, good or bad, whatever it is. But the one who loves him, the one who will trust him, he will remain in her domain of love, where the rules can be bent. The divergence can be made. The ships and the boats can be arranged for a river to be crossed. If you get a mountain in your road, yes, there will be a tunnel created for you. Or maybe somebody will pick you up and take you there. Yes, something like that always happens in our life. We think the situation is so difficult, impossible. Out of blue, something happens and we are relieved, right? That is how that is exactly like crossing the big mountain with our efforts, right? We have experienced that so many times in our life. So all this act, for all this, ask for active intervention. Active intervention. And active intervention is done only by Swayam Bhagavan himself. And that freedom she has given him. But only with her order. If she says no, he cannot do anything. And she usually doesn't say no for Shraddhavans. Usually is a wrong term, never says no for Shraddhavans. And he goes on working on everybody's plan. Not every year. Not like our nation, every 5 years we have plans, right? Not like our calendar. The calendar goes, January starts, we start planning. Oh, this year should be like this. And the plan fails. His plan never fails. But he is planning. Why his plans never fail? He is ready to change his plan at every second, at every microsecond, at every nanosecond. He goes on changing. He is ready to change for his sons and daughters. Keep that in mind. That is Natha Swabhyam. So remember, when we say Natha Swabhyam, actually we are asking for his active intervention in our life. What is the real translation of Natha Swabhyam? Let his plan prevail. What is the meaning? Let his plan prevail in my life. Let his plan prevail in my life. Let his plan prevail in my life. That is Natha Swabhyam. Understood? That is the meaning of the word Natha Swabhyam. And if you are in Bhakti Bhava Chaitanya, that is the devotion sentience, be sure that he is not going to leave you like that. He is going to do active intervention at every step. Whether you are aware of it or not, you may be sleeping. But still, he doesn't sleep. He's working whole night. You must remember that. Okay? But why didn't Babu insist on saying Natha Sovid, Natha Sovid, Natha Sovid? As I said, this is a prayer. Okay? And this prayer has to be made again and again. Why? He requires it? No. We require it. For? Why? What for? Because our mind forgets the things very easily. Whatever we have said 10 minutes back, we forget now. Whatever we plan on 1st of January, right? If we are conscious on 1st January morning. Many people get up with headache. I don't blame anyone. Okay, enjoy it the way you want, agreed? But be in your limits, be in healthy limits. That is the best way, right? But we forget our plan. Maximum, whatever plan we have made on 1st of January, it continues for 2nd January. Maximum to 7th January. Beyond that, everything is there it was before. And again we remember only on 31st December of that year. Hey, I have made such a plan, what happened? But he never forgets. Whatever plan you make, whatever plan you make, he registers in his own, not head, in his heart. And he knows what my child is trying to plan, what my child is trying to do, perform or achieve. According to that, he's ready to help him, so he goes on changing his plan. But that does not mean he's weird personality. He's haphazard. He's not at a haphazard. He's the most well organized. Though he's changing his plan at every nanosecond, he's not haphazard. He's most perfectly well organized. And he never fails. He never makes mistakes, that we have to understand. Right? So, come what may, we should always say, Nath Savet. Because the minute we pray Natha Samvit, we say Natha Samvit from the core of our heart. When our failure becomes our success, when our failure becomes our success, our loss becomes our gain, and our sins become our strength. What I'm saying? Our sins become our strength. But the minute from the core of our heart, we pray to Him, Natha Samvit. Are we saying, I love you? Right? There is a lot of strength. People many times go on seeking power, big mantras. Hi, chanting this big mantra is going to give me big power. We say, that person is so powerful, huh? He is spiritually very powerful person. Are you are yourself powerful. But you are already directly connected to Him. You have to say only once that I love you from the core of your heart. And He is all yours. So you will remain connected to Him only. You do not require any agent, any mediocre interference between you and Him. Keep that in mind. Right? Because anybody else other than you is going to be a mediocre intermediator. Keep that in mind. Who can be the best agent for you than yourself? Only you. So be your own agent and say Natha Savet. Right? Agreed?
Yes,
so all of you, have you understood, all of you?
Yes.
Or in Natha Savet?
Yes.
Right? So be very clear in your mind. Whatever we speak, whatever we do, carries definitely what? Yes. We are the ones who should allow Natha Savet to prevail in our life. Let His plan prevail. That is in our hands because we have been given Karma Swatantra by Mahachakadamba. Let us use that to say Natha Savet. Let us see your lives start changing. Rama Rama Atma Rama. We chant, right? And it changes the whole world within and without. The inner world as well as the outer world. Everything starts changing. But that change is always how? Soft, slow, and gentle. Soft, slow, and gentle. Exactly like His nature. soft, slow and gentle. And at the same time, he has contrast qualities always. Wherever needed, his plan is most hard-hitting. Most hard-hitting. Most vigorous. And most tough. Right. Most tough. Why? Not for you to carry that burden, but to remove the burden from your heads. To kill your enemies. To remove the obstacles in your path. He has to hit hard at times. He does that. Okay? But you should understand this is being done for me. Okay? That is Natha Samhita. Okay? Let us say Natha Samhita again. Natha Samhita. Natha Samhita. Natha Samhita. Love you all. Love you, love you, love you, love you, love you. Love you always, love you forever. Love you, love you, love you. Love you.